That's the buzzer. Officially in the house. Holy freaking mites, man. I should have brought some suntan lotion. This doesn't work.
No, I wouldn't lie to you.
This has never happened to me before. I'm nervous. I'm like real nervous because I really want to do good for you tonight. I really want to be funny. I hope I'm funny. Funny? You like the scallop I'm wearing?
Yeah.
I used to be a country western singer. First it was Johnny Cash. Then it was Johnny Paycheck. And I was Johnny Flat Fucking Broke. This is not a test. For the next This reminds me of a date that went really well. Speaking of dating, I'm single, so I'm dating. I hate dating. It sucks. You ever heard of that book, Men from Mars, Women from Venus?
Yeah.
I dated a lot of women from Uranus. Whoever named that planet Uranus, anyway?
Some asshole.
Probably some asshole. Was that you? Did you name it? Anyway. Oh, it feels good to be on a New York stage. It feels good to be anywhere.
There you go.
I thought about something. Captain Crunch was found murdered in Central Park last night.
Yeah.
Also, the church rabbit was found strangled in his Manhattan apartment. Apparently, there's a serial killer on the loose. Oh! You want corny? You got corny. Fuck it. Had a blind date. A seeing eye dog bit me. Thank you very much. You want corny? You got it. You know, I was riding the elevator. How many of you ride the elevators? Come on. Yeah, don't you hate it when you get on the first floor and then some fucker comes in and they press for the second floor? Don't you hate that shit?
Yeah.
And then you look him over, you look him up and down and think, he's comparable. He can walk up a flight of stairs, right? And then the second, and if you're with somebody, when he gets off on the second floor, you like start talking about him. What a lazy fuck. Couldn't he fucking take the stairs? Yeah, it's just an observance I had. Well, it's good to be here. My first time here. I'm a virgin. Glad to be here. Anyway, I just came out of rehab. Seriously, I just came out of rehab. Thank you. Some sympathetic folks here. For the past 2 years, I've been hooked on phonics. But now I'm back on cocaine and my life has improved ever since. Thank you. My mom liked that one. She said, yeah, tell that one. Speaking of moms, let's talk about parents a little bit, shall we? We all have them, I think. Some people I know have been created somehow. I don't know how they were created. Like they reproduce through asexual reproduction. Their parents split in half like amoebas. My parents, although I like to think that, they had sex. My parents had sex. And I just can't imagine my mother going, Oh, Dominic. I can't fucking imagine it. I'm going to be really quick because I got to pee. Just thought I'd announce that to you. Thank you very much, thank you. I want to talk about a sexual position. One that I like the most, dog style.
Wow!
It's my favorite. My favorite sexual position. And we didn't even invent it, either. Every fucking animal in the kingdom fucking invented it. We didn't. But we like it best. Because on a date is really ugly, you know. It's a saving grace. I told that to my mom senior. I said, should I say that one? He said, yes, go in peace. Get the fuck out of the rectory. Exact words, get the fuck out of it. I also like dog style because, you know, if I have to fake an orgasm, it makes it a hell of a lot easier. thank you. I keep the Jergens hand lotion handy. So I make some primal calls. In the shower. What the fuck is the concept of sex in the shower? The one thing, you gotta be a fucking contortionist to do it right. Right? If you do it right, you got one foot in the fucking sink. You got the other one in the fucking hamper. Hopefully it's not full. So you gotta be like, oh jeez. You know, you're doing it right, you talk to her, how's it feel, honey? And if you do it right, how's it feel, honey? Because the alternative is that your back is to the fucking shower, and that's the time when some fucker in the floor does the evening dishes, right? Burns your asshole. Burns your... You guys like fucking and cursing and shit. You want it? You got it. You paid for it? You got curses. Fuck it. Anyway. It's good to be here. Let me just blow out a little bit. I'm not going to talk about political shit. I'm not going to go there. Nah, fuck it. I'll go there. Bob Dole... Remember when Bob Dole said cigarette smoking isn't addictive?
Yeah.
Yeah, right. I'm like, I fucking cum blue cheese dressing. Fucking ass. Fucking ass. I dated this one chick. She was wacky, man. She was just totally wacky. She hooked up the clapper to a vibrator. To get her to come, I had to give her a standing ovation. Hey, keep clapping, she's coming. She's coming right through the door right now as we speak. Bad name for a racehorse. Bad name for a racehorse. Hung like a human. Don't bet on that fucking horse. Three fucking hooves. That's not bad name for a racehorse. Oh, shit. Lastly, wouldn't it be great if there was a place called Cognito? Think about this. You can go to Cognito, call a friend, and say, I'm incognito.
Trevor Travel, incognito.
What the fuck was that? By the way, let's talk about farts. Fuck it. Farting. It looked fart while you were walking. It comes out like a lot of little farts, doesn't it? And the farts come out like in cadence. How about farting on the subway?
That's
twice. Why not? Well, who's gonna know it's you, right? Just look very angrily at the guy next to you. You look great. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Mr. Frank Balducci.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Well, happy Valentine's Day. Thank you. And I don't have a girlfriend.
Yes. Oh, yes.
Don't have. No, I don't. Thank you. Holy smokes. Don't have a girlfriend. Any lovers out there? Yeah? Any, come on, round of applause. Anybody,
you have a girl.
Any lovers? Nobody's made love in this city?
You don't have
love. Nobody cares anyway. Ah, jeez. I think my problem is that I'm told that I'm too nice to women. I'm too nice to women, and a friend suggested that I should treat my women badly in order for them to respect me. So, I took this one woman out to a restaurant, and while we were going over the menu, I asked her, well, you want to start off with a shrimp cocktail? You bitch! But of course, that didn't work. I got good news. I just got an agent. And I'm so very excited about it. Thank you. I'm very happy about it. Matter of fact, he thought it was a good idea I do this show here on Valentine's Day. And he neglected to remember the fact that I don't have a girlfriend. Apparently, he's got a better sense of humor than I do. Yeah, I think I'm going to fire that bastard, come to think of it. Oh, God. I'd just like to tell you this. It was a complaint that women have that I heard about. The fact that, I don't know how to put this, but guys, you're not spending too much time down there. Guys, let me give you a little advice. Take my word for it. If you want to keep your woman happy, you have to eat your way right up to your girl's heart. No doubt it. Guys, pretend that you're a coal miner. Put on a mining helmet with a little light on the front. Sing the song, I'm working in a coal mine, going Guys, you like camping, right? So pretend you're camping. You know, build a little campfire, toast some marshmallows, break out a guitar, sing Kumbaya, 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 Kumbaya. Show a woman that you're there, show a woman that you care. Am I right, ladies? Help me out here. Oh, God. On that note, I would like to tell you that my mom is here this evening. My mom is here. The reason why I am here is because about 32 years ago, my mom and dad had a moment of weakness. And according to my mom, it was just a moment. You know, I am sick and tired of blind dates. I swear to God, no more blind dates for me. The last blind date I had, her seeing eye dog bit me. No more. You know, you can never really judge a person on the late comer. Oh, I didn't mean anything about, okay. You can never really adequately get to know somebody on a first date, I think. In all fairness, there was this one girl I dated, and she kept referring to her pet bulldog as her child. Do you know people like this that refer to their pets as their children? It kind of annoys me. So she referred to her pet bulldog as her child, and then when I went back to her place, I saw the bulldog, and I did see a striking resemblance. Same look. Same look on her face. Then I went out with another girl, and she told me she read somewhere that a man's genitalia is directly related to his intellect, his intelligence. In that, a man's intelligence is directly related to the size, directly related to the size of his genitalia. The smarter the man, the smaller the penis. And I said, My love life has been going so terribly. I call it the psychic line. Even Dionne Warwick said I was hopeless. Oh, you ever notice that they made so many different horror flicks about different holidays? Like they made Halloween, they made Friday the 13th. They even made one about Christmas called Silent Night, Deadly Night. They even made one about Mother's Day. You know, why don't they make a horror movie about Valentine's Day, right? I guess it would go something like this. Honey, I love you. Ah, jeez. But it gets even worse. I dated this one girl. She hooked up the clapper to a vibrator. To get an orgasm, I had to give her a standing ovation. Thank you very much. You were swell. Nobody minds?
I'm taking off my coat for you, sweetie.
Oh, thank you, baby. All right, you know,
get started here? Okay. Now, my agent thought it'd be a good idea to do this show, but, I networked with my agent, and he booked me for this show, basically a professional agreement where he books me for shows, I get him laid.
Oh.
Well, it's really good to be here. But I think my agent might be having a better time. There's a complaint I heard about from women. There's a lot of complaints, right? Right, Henry? A lot of complaints that guys have. Henry, look at Henry. He's like, yeah, I know. I hear you, brother. Don't believe me. I know what you're feeling. Don't look nervous. I'm up here. He's like, oh, shit, don't talk to me. Fuck, you had to make me sit in the front row? I'm sorry, brother. Anyway, there's a complaint, a particular complaint I want to tell you. Tell you guys about. Guys, I always say this. Alright, three words. Eat more pussy. Eat more pussy. What's the big friggin' deal? Am I right, ladies?
Yeah.
I don't go down there enough. And there may be some women, but not many. Some women are a little self-conscious about a man going down there. They're like, oh, no, come up here, come up here. Ladies, let them go down there. This is a man's obligation to do it. Let them go down there and do it. Guys, if you're a little squeamish about going down there, I don't know, pretend you're a coal miner. Put on a little mining helmet with a little light on the front so you see what you're doing. And sing that old coal miner song, I'm working in a coal miner, going down there, working in a coal miner. Next time you hear that song, you either think of me at home. I know that guy. Honey, where did I call him? What are you talking about? Don't you remember? Guys, we like camping, haven't you? Like camping? Little macho thing to do. Right? Pretend, when you go down there, pretend you're camping. When you go down there, build a little campfire. Toast some marshmallows. Break out a guitar and sing Kumbaya. 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 Put the sheet over her knee. It makes a good A-frame tent. And tell her, I'm going into the tent now. I'm in the tent. I'm in the tent. She loves that. Show a woman you care. Show a woman you can go down there. Am I right, ladies?
Yeah.
I thought so. Yeah.
Because if you're there, I'm going.
You know, at county fairs, they have pie eating contests. Why don't they have pussy eating contests, right? Pussy eating contests. Guys, can you imagine the spread along the tables? Goodness sakes! Now why not? A pussy is in the shape of a little pie, isn't it? Cherry pie! Right? I'm looking for the cherry pie myself. Where's the cherry pie? Jacques Cousteau. You remember Jacques Cousteau?
Yeah.
That sounds like a great lover, right? Doesn't seem like he'd be a great lover because it doesn't seem like a guy would be squeamish about eating pussy. Well, he's an explorer, isn't he? And what does he explore? Seafood!
Yes!
Oh my goodness sakes, you guys are crazy. Now, guys, I gotta admit, guys, I'm with you. We have to be more creative. We have to be better lovers. We gotta be, not for us to be great lovers, we really gotta work hard. For a woman to be a great lover, all she has to do is be there. Just be there. Honey, am I a good lover?
They're here.
And really, ladies, you can't fuck up sucking dick, right? Basically, if the dick's in the mouth, you do it fine! Right? Very little margin for error. And if she's doing it badly, it's still great, right? speaking of genitalia. Well, that word genitalia, isn't it interesting? It sounds like it could be an Italian cold cut. Hey Joey, you want a quarter pound of the genitalia? Nah, Vinny and Vinny got a half a pound of expanding company tonight. Genitalia sounds like it could be a country.
Yes.
Off the coast of New Zealand.
And you can come live.
Yeah, my friend Tommy's genitalia. And man, he's got a lot of balls too, you know? I'm gonna try something new. One time I was reading in one of those journals, and I had a friend of mine come up next to me and start talking to me. And I can't really concentrate on reading if a guy's having a conversation with me. I mean, I gotta admit. So I thought to myself, wouldn't it be funny if our penises were having a conversation? I guess it would go something like this, right? Hey, Johnny, how's it hanging? To the left. How about yourself? Dead center. So what have you been doing lately?
as usual, peeing, fucking, and yourself? And peeing, getting jerked off. So, you heard about Harvey?
Vasectomy.
Oh. Yeah, he had a lot of he had a lot of balls.
Yeah, but not no more.
So listen, you done yet?
Not with you staring at me.
What about you?
Not yet.
Okay, now I'm done. So listen, you take care of yourself, okay? You too. See you later. Thank you very much. Have a good night. I found out I could now fart in front of her.
Oh!
It didn't even graduate from belching or picking my nose in front of her because it happened quite accidentally. Sitting on the couch watching TV with her and then... She was like really cool. She didn't dye an eyelash or anything. She was a real trooper. Next up, I'm going to try peeing the door open. Put the seat down. So how are we doing tonight? Just make fun of my freaking audience, that's all. Do you want me to be filthy? Should I be filthy tonight?
Sure.
All you filthy people. Since when I put the responsibility on you, some of you are offended. There's a lot of gripes that women have against guys, justifiably, but there's one gripe in particular I want to tell you about. Guys, three words to remedy it: eat more pussy. Eat more pussy. Am I right, ladies?
Yes!
Yeah, come on, eat it, come on!
Bring it over here.
There may be some women that are only self-conscious about a man going down there. I have a funny feeling that none of you are self-conscious about a man going down there. But to the guys, if you're really squeamish about going down there, and when you go down there, pretend you're a coal miner. When you go down there, put on a little mining helmet with a little light on the front so you can see what you're doing. And sing that old coal miner song. No working in a coal mine, going down, 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 working in a coal mine. Woo! Guys like, thank you. Guys like camping? When you go down there, pretend you're camping. Light a little campfire. Throw some marshmallows. Break out the guitar and sing Kumbaya, Kumbaya, my lord, Kumbaya. If you put the sheet over her knee, it makes it tense. And tell her, honey, I'm going in the tent now. I'm in the tent, I'm out of the tent, I'm in the tent. Try it. Try it. I know you like that one. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. I want to talk to you about a place that I keep seeing. It's an eatery called Avon Pain. Is that correct? Someone says, no, it's Pat. No, it's fucking Pain. It's fucking... Have you heard this place?
Yeah.
I wouldn't eat at that place because, first of all, the croissant's like $150. And I would be a little bit hesitant in eating a place that has the word pain in the name of it. And sushi. Yeah, that could be a real mean Japanese prank on us Americans. Eating raw fish? That'll be fucking crazy. Come on. And a sushi chef. I mean, isn't that an oxymoron? Doesn't being a chef constitute cooking something? You know what? Well, what makes a sushi chef? What, that he's handy with a knife? So my friend Raul from the Bronx is pretty handy with a fish plate. That doesn't make him a sushi chef. Depends on the garments. Remember this? Diapers for adults. Imagine being the ad executive for the company that produces Depends undergarments. Can you imagine the commercial? Some old rickety guy, you know? When my son was just a baby, I used to change his diapers. Now that he's a man, he changes mine. It depends undergarments like an old bob with my son. And it's good to know people with a variety of control problem, which necessitates them wearing diapers, is still in the workforce. Yeah, Carl? Yeah, I'm gonna get back to you on that account. Yeah, I just went cocky poopy poopy cocky. I just like saying cocky poopy poopy cocky. Took me a month to get it right. Another thing.
My favorite sexual position. Well, other choices out there. Dog style is my favorite sexual position. It's my favorite sexual position because if like the girl is ugly, it's like a saving grace. I just keep the Jarius lotion handy, and at the appropriate time I'll go, But it's not just me. There are some women that are just absolutely totally whacked out. For example, there's this one woman I dated, she hooked up the fabric to a vibrator. To get her orgasm, I had to give her a standing ovation. Anyway, thank you very much. This is fun. Thank you.
One person self-conscious. Mind if I smoke?
Yes.
Okay. Don't you like those lighters? They get those safety things on them. It's supposed to be childproof. Meanwhile, the child can light it, but adults can't. I tried quitting smoking. I tried using the patch. They were very hard to light. Then I tried chewing on them. But my sister says, no, you have to wear it on your arm. You know, I couldn't find a really good suit to put it on, so it didn't match. I got a couple of things to tell you. I have an agent that's a real, he's a nice guy. We have sort of a professional agreement with one another. Basically, he books me for shows, and I get him laid. Well, it's good to be here. I'm feeling my agent maybe having a better time. Do you like this getup I'm wearing? Thank you, your mercy is appreciated. I used to be a country western singer. Oh yeah. But for your friends, it was Johnny Cash. Then there was Johnny Paycheck. And now it's Johnny Flat Fucking Broke. But comedy's been pretty good to me. I even have a girlfriend. And she's really nice and sweet. And I really do believe we've reached a higher level of love with one another. Because I found I can now fart in front of her. I didn't even graduate from like belching or picking my nose in front of it because it happened quite accidentally. Just sitting there on the couch watching television and then. Now, but she was really cool about it, didn't bat an eyelash, a real trooper. Next time I'm going to try peeing with the door open, with the seat down.
Oh no.
Who's going out? Anybody who's going, out with anybody? A round of applause? Or say, help! Whatever. What do we think? Anybody engaged yet? You know, notice, the one thing I notice about ladies is that, you know, she'll tell the man she's with, they just get engaged, they're just fiancé and everything, and they're like, oh, honey, there's a special moment for the two of us. Meanwhile, they go back to work and go, ah! And then the guy calls his friends and say, yeah, I got engaged. And they're like, what are you? Crazy? Invite me to the wedding. But I'm lucky I have a nice girlfriend, you know, and the dating scene was just getting really lousy to me. It's totally terrible. I've never heard that book, Men from Mars, Women from Venus.
Okay.
I've dated a lot of women from Uranus. It's great, man. There was this one girl, she was so whacked out, so wacky. Get this, she hooked up the clapper to her vibrator. To get an orgasm, I had to give her a standing ovation. And she liked sushi. It's, I don't know about sushi, right? That could be a cool little Japanese prank on us Americans. We don't sell people or fish. What are we, freaking crazy? And a sushi chef. And that could be an oxymoron. I mean, isn't being a chef costume having to cook something? And what does it take to be a sushi chef? Why, you gotta be gifted, talented with a knife? You know, my friend Raul from the Bronx is pretty gifted with a switchblade, you know? That doesn't make him a sushi chef. O.J. Simpson is pretty handy with a knife himself, right? You won't find him behind the bar at some sushi restaurant going, this food is very fresh tonight. Uh-uh, you're not gonna find that. We're totally tasteless. Have you ever heard of the Penn's undergarments?
Diapers for adults. That's how I see it. How would you like